Each year, 30 million passengers pass through LaGuardia's 72 gates. Keeping the airport open whilst hitting construction milestones is critical.
It is the closest airport to downtown Manhattan, so it is enormously convenient for millions and millions of people.
The Terminal C team must keep at least 33 gates open at all times.
Only when I have built new capacity will I then turn to tearing down old capacity.
But building that new capacity over at Terminal C is proving to be no easy task.
We're going to have to put a new pile in that one, because that one I can't save.
At the construction site of Concourse F, inspectors have found water in some piles. The steel tubes have broken as they were driven into the ground. They must be replaced.
The idea is to meet the schedule, but we have these unforeseen occurrences that we have to deal with, you know?
Superintendent Rich Pennella must complete the piling fast, so the next phase, pouring the concrete foundation, can begin. It's crucial they keep all phases of work on track to avoid both the build and flights grinding to a halt.
We're gonna pump it out, you're gonna check it, and we're gonna go. We're not waiting a while, we can't. You can think of it like dominoes. One goes down, knocks the next one down. And if one piece falls awry, then it kind of screws things up.
And there's more bad news from Inspector Unique. His camera reveals that there's a severe bend in this pile.
So it's losing its shape at around 59 feet. You can see that the camera kind of resting on the side wall of the pile. It should be mostly in the middle, somewhere hanging free. That means the pile is starting to become horizontal. You can see that at one point, this pile hit something so hard that it caused it to deform. We can't approve it.
But what is causing the damage? A clue lies beneath Manhattan. 24,000 years ago, a vast glacier covered New York. It was taller than the Empire State Building and thousands of miles wide. The glacier moved north at the end of the last ice age. But it still creates problems for the builders at LaGuardia Airport today. Buried up to 125 feet beneath soft landfill, clay and sand are layers of boulders that the retreating glacier left behind. If a pile hits one of these massive rocks, it could split the hollow steel tube, snap the weld, or send it wildly off course. That's why driving piles at LaGuardia Airport is a bit of a lottery.
When it bends too much, it compromises the integrity of the pile, so the pile can't hold up the same amount of load that it was designed for. It's gonna be rejected, and when it's rejected, you either add one or two extra piles to basically make up for the bad pile.
Rich orders the rigs to hammer in 11 additional piles, hoping they avoid the same fate. He puts his team into overdrive, ramping up pile production to keep the phases of the build on track. In a matter of days, inspectors are able to sign off the new straight piles.
We have two rigs going, second rig over there. Each rig gets about four piles a day.
With the piles driven into the ground, the team feed cages of steel rebar down inside.
They put the rebar in for rigidity.
They then fill the pile with concrete.
When they pour the concrete in, it hardens, so it's more of a rigid type of column rather than something that's flexible like a straw.
Rich and Jolene's team have almost 200 piles to drive for Concourse F.
They have a lot of work ahead of them, so we're trying to keep ahead of the game.